Welcome back. This video is about the top 10 warnings in Revit 2023. I'll start off by listing the top 10 things to look for in Revit. Of course, there can be infinite number of warnings that can be associated with a specific model element. So we're not going to go through every single one of those, but what we're going to do is touch on the most important warnings. Things to look for in a Revit project. The first one would be the model upgrade warnings. When you upgrade a model from, let's say, from 2019 to 2023, you're going to get specific type of warnings that is different than if you had a, for example, a wall interfering with a window. We'll look for how to find warnings for a selected element. We'll look for messages and warnings you can ignore. We'll also look at exporting warnings to a specific file, an HTML file, which you can share with your team members. And, you know, this will become a historical record of the project on that day. We'll look at error dialogues. We'll look at listing all errors and warnings associated with a specific element or a message. We'll display elements involved in errors, select elements by ID, select an element ID number, and the last thing is when you get a serious error has occurred, you need to take some action at that point. So we'll cover that as well. So let's get started. All right, let's take a look at how to open a project and go through the model upgrade. So you have the option of upgrading it or cancel the upgrade. If you click on that link, what happens when you are upgrading a model in Revit? It will tell you a little bit more specifically what actually is happening behind the scenes. Okay, so obviously you can upgrade your RVT files, your RFA files, Revit families, and Revit templates, RTE files. Those are three types of template of file types you can upgrade. Open the model within the software, or you can double click on it to open, but I don't recommend that, by the way. Don't do that because it may open in different version of Revit. You can upgrade the model or cancel it in the middle of it. And if your project have work sharing, you have to look at the help menu and find out what happens if you have work sharing. Central model upgrade is a little bit different than cloud model upgrade. And some models cannot be upgraded within Revit. If you are a structural engineer and trying to upgrade an analytical model, then it's another story as well. Models that are on BIM 360 have a different procedure as well. So make sure you understand what's involved before you attempt to do that. Okay, so these are all in the help menu. All right, so let's move on to the next topic, which is, you know, if you want to cancel the upgrade, you can say yes, cancel. Yes, are you sure? You can cancel the upgrade. If you do go through with the upgrade, you can generate a report. This would be an HTML file, which I'm going to show you right now. I made those reports for several models. So I will go ahead and open that report, and you can see the report. In the report, we have, depending on the type of elements in the model, in this case, we have rebars that can be bent, cuts in on concrete, rebars have duplicate elements, and elements that cannot be joined. Okay, so not a big deal. You know, you can basically ignore those warnings and just keep going with the model upgrade. If you copy the element ID that is in the report, you can go back, switch back to the Revit model, and you can open the model that you want to look at. And when you open it, you'll be able to select the element by ID. But I'm here showing you that you could also be getting additional warnings as you open the model as well. Okay, so if you do get warnings, what you should do is automatically export the report before the warning goes away. We did copy the element ID. We go to the manage menu, select by ID, paste the element ID using Control V as in Victor, and click on the show button. If you can see it or it's under something, you click OK and you can turn the model around. You'll be able to see that element. This happens to be a concrete grade beam that is causing the warning. Okay, so you can take the proper action. You can also, while the element is selected, you can look at its properties, instance properties and type properties, and here's another report for an architectural model where the wall part cannot be properly adjusted, and that's a common warning, so it should be ignored and just keep going with them. If you only have one warning per model, that's really good. That's, you're very fortunate. All right, same thing. We're gonna select that by ID, and it happens to be this wall over here that's in blue right now. So we will isolate that wall using a selection box, and you can look at it from different angles and determine whether it's worth the trouble or just simply ignore the whole thing and keep going. So not all warnings are very serious. Okay. All right. Let's take a look at the next topic, which is finding warnings for selected elements, which is something that is kind of important. So if you are, so the question is, how do you find a warning for a selected element? Okay, there's an article about that in the help menu. Basically, it's under the modify menu warning panel. So I'm going to go here to the of course, I have the element ID. I'm going to search for that. It's this mullion over here in the window. That's the. Then I will click on the show related warnings in the modify menu, and that's the warning that is associated with that mullion. The warning essentially is saying the mullion is duplicated. Of course, that's not good. Huh? So the solution obviously is to delete the extra mullion. Which messages and warnings you can ignore? You can ignore warnings that require no action. Okay. Usually if they appear in the bottom right of your screen, then they are of a low importance and require no action. If they appear in the middle of the screen, they are of more importance. If they appear on the top of the screen, especially the top left, that means they have some serious consequences. So depending on how high it is on the screen. Exporting a warning to a file. We've done that earlier. When you export that, it will become an HTML file. You can double click on it. It will open in your browser. And you can, every element in Revit has a unique element ID, which you can copy and search for it inside your BIM model. And as you can see here, there's a lot of identical instances in the same place. That, as I said, this is typical for people who are working in the model very fast without paying attention to warnings. So I would say that the best practice to check the warnings maybe once a week on your project if you are a BIM manager, and don't let them pile up, because they tend to, add up very quickly into the hundreds and thousands, and then it becomes a nightmare to manage. How do you list all errors and warnings associated with a specific message? So it's simple as just opening the folder that contains that message. So back in the model, if the folder is collapsed, you can click on the plus sign to open it. You see what's underneath. Next topic is display elements involved in errors. Again, I'm trying to be efficient as possible here, so don't spend way too much time on this video. So now that you know what the important topics are, you can read them yourself and dig a little bit deeper into that. So we have select element by ID, find an element ID number, and the last one was warning, a serious error has occurred. Let's take a look at that. This is a very important type of warning, and it should not be taken lightly. So if this happens, then you should pause and read exactly what it says and take action on it. What you do at this time will determine whether or not you lose all your work. So it is strongly recommended that you do a save as to a new file. Okay, a new file name. Don't use the same name, use a different file name. And check for specific things. For example, after you do a file save as, check for any hot fixes or updates for your software. And usually that takes care of the problem. If it doesn't, then perform an audit on your file and check your computer that you are working on. Make sure you have the Windows updates and check your network connections and then check your Revit journal. Tips for warnings in Revit. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you. If you enjoyed this video and find it informative, please subscribe to this channel and leave a comment below about any topics that you would like us to cover in the future. Thank you.